Good morning and welcome to worship this morning. We're glad that you could be joining us here. Behind me, the Christmas tree grows with ornaments every week. That is part of our hope and anticipation of Easter, or of, what was I talking about? That's the hope and anticipation of Christmas that we live into in our Advent season. Behind me, you'll see the ornaments that people have been making of their families and the garland that is made out of memories from Christmas. So it can be a special message. It can be a meaningful part of Christmas for you. We've linked those together so that we can see that we're still bound to each other, even though we're far apart this Christmas season. If you would like to add to those things, either the garland or the ornament, both are available in a brown paper packet that's located under the canopy, Monday through Friday, 8:30 to 5. And you can pick that up anytime. It's no contact. And when you're done, you can just drop it in on our drop box under the canopy, right where you picked it up from. And that gets checked a couple times a day. If you haven't already, I invite you to go grab some communion, some bread, and some wine, and participate with us this morning in Holy Communion. The last thing I have to say is that we are saying goodbye to Pastor Jennifer on the 20th, the end of the month, but next week we'll celebrate her time with us here and we'll send her with a blessing. And so we hope you can join us for that worship service and show her your appreciation over these last years. With that, we will begin our worship service with the lighting of the Advent candles.
The prophet Isaiah shared a word with the grieving world, a vision of vibrant renewal. All of creation will be glad. Even the earth itself will praise God.
Dry places like deserts will be full of blooming life.
Joy will grow like new crocuses, poking up through the ground and spreading out in the front yard.
The whole earth will sing praises to God, and so will we.
As we wait faithfully for God's time, we light the candles of hope, peace, and joy.
In God's time of joy, all sorrow and sighing will leave us.
Let us pray. Stir up the wills of your faithful people, Lord God, and open our ears to the words of your prophets, that anointed by your Spirit, we may testify to your light through Jesus Christ, our Savior and Lord, who lives and reigns with you in the Holy Spirit, one God, now and forever. Amen.
A reading from Isaiah. The Spirit of the Lord God is upon me, because the Lord has anointed me. He has sent me to bring good news to the oppressed, to bind up the brokenhearted, to proclaim liberty to the captives and release to the prisoners, to proclaim the year of the Lord's favor and the day of vengeance of our God, to comfort all who mourn, to provide for those who mourn in Zion, to give them a garland instead of ashes, the oil of gladness instead of mourning, the mantle of praise instead of a faint spirit. They will be called oaks of righteousness, the planting of the Lord to display his glory. They shall build up their ancient ruins. They shall raise up the former devastations. They shall repair the ruined cities, the devastations of many generations. For I, the Lord, love justice. I hate robbery and wrongdoing. I will faithfully give them their recompense, and I will make an everlasting covenant with them. Their descendants shall be known among the nations, and their offspring among the peoples. All who see them shall acknowledge that they are a people whom the Lord has blessed. I will greatly rejoice in the Lord. My whole being shall exult in my God, for he has clothed me with the garments of salvation. He has covered me with the robe of righteousness, as a bridegroom decks himself with a garland, and for a bride adorns herself with her jewels. For as the earth brings forth its shoots, and as a garden causes what it is sown in it to spring up, so the Lord God will cause righteousness and praise to spring up before all the nations.
The Holy Gospel according to St. John, the first chapter. There was a man sent from God whose name was John. He came as a witness to testify to the light, so that all might believe through him. He himself was not the light, but he came to testify to the light. This is the testimony given by John when the Jews sent priests and Levites from Jerusalem to ask him, "Who are you?" He confessed and did not deny it, but confessed, "I am not the Messiah." And they asked him, "What then? Are you Elijah?" He said, "I am not." "Are you the prophet?" He answered, "No." Then they said to him, "Who are you? Let us have an answer for those who sent us. What do you say about yourself?" He said, "I am the voice of the one crying out in the wilderness, 'Make straight the way of the Lord,' as the prophet Isaiah said." Now they had been sent from the Pharisees, and they asked him, "Why then are you baptizing if you are neither the Messiah, nor Elijah, nor a prophet?" John answered them, "I baptize with water. Among you stands one whom you do not know, the one who is coming after me. I am not worthy to untie the thong of his sandal." This took place in Bethany, across the Jordan, where John was baptizing. The Gospel of our Lord. Excuse me one second. I'm gonna try and light that. Managed to light it without burning the church down. I'm happy. So I've always kind of had this fascination with fire. I was told that when I worked as a camp counselor, it was just part of like the requirements for being one, was that we all had to be little mini pyromaniacs to enjoy the job. And it definitely was kind of true, because I was, even though I worked kind of exclusively among those who only did day camps, but whenever we were at a site where we got to light fires, because, you know, like people who worked on site, they were lighting multiple ones a day, we maybe got one or two a month. We went crazy, just for the chance to be near and light and see fire. I mean, fire is a simple thing. And as we know in Albert Lea, as we've experienced this past month, it can be a destructive thing. But yet, I find myself, every time I light a candle or I'm near a bonfire or a campfire, there is just something peaceful about staring at a lit flame. It's a simple thing, But yet, a simple candle can be so important. It's a lifeline when we run out of power. It lights the way in the darkness. It guarantees we can see where we're going, or we have a bit of warmth in the cold. And yet, a candle in the darkness, even a single candle in the darkness, can show us what we know is there, right? When the lights are out, we know that what was in the room when the lights were on is still in that room. But sometimes we need a candle to remind us it's there, so we don't trip over the chair or the toys or whatever is in the way. The candle, the light, the candle shows the light which reveals what is there. John likes to talk a lot about light. It's one of his favorite things to talk about, I think, because he often reminds us that Jesus is the light. And Jesus as the light, he's reminding us that Jesus is here. Jesus is already here, and that we are called, that he are called to be the candles that show others what's already in the room, which is Christ. But yet that can be a little scary, right? Because John doesn't just talk about showing the light, he talks about testifying to the light or witnessing the light, you know, actually talking to others about Jesus. I was talking with a couple of friends this week, and we're like, yeah, we as Lutherans, we're not so good about that talking about Jesus thing or telling testimonies like you find in other churches or other denominations. And I remember stopping and then saying, except at camp. If you've ever been to a Christian camp, you know there is, when once you hit the middle school, high school age, there's almost always a night where you sit with your cabin or your group around a campfire and you tell faith stories. You tell the story of where your life meets God's, your story meets God's story. A moment where you felt God work in your life, or you needed God. And for some reason, when we are seated around a fire and looking at the light, it's a lot easier to talk about the light of the world. Because it's really easy to say, well, I'm not John the Baptist or Paul or any of the other disciples or apostles or Amos or Isaiah or any of the grand prophets of old. We're not Huldah or Anna or any of those great women preachers of the Bible. We're just us. I'm not a, right? I may be a pastor, but you're thinking to yourself, maybe I'm not a pastor or a deacon. I'm not trained to do this. How do we tell God's story? How do we tell our story? How do we tell the story of where those two things meet? And see, that's what the people in the story who are questioning John were kind of demanding to know. What gives you the right to stand out here in the wilderness and talk about God? Are you the Messiah? No. Are you Elijah? No. Well, are you at least then a prophet? No. And I'm sure that frustrated his questioners, but I think for us, it can give us a little bit of hope, because we're not the Messiah or Elijah or a prophet. We can be what John says he was, a voice, just a voice. A voice crying out from where he was and pointing, talking about God, pointing to Christ in our midst, being a candle showing the light of Jesus, the one whom they did not know was coming, but John knew was coming, to those who needed to hear, to see, and to be shown the way. So this Advent, Christmas, and even Epiphany season, where we surround ourselves with candles and lanterns and lights, remember why we do so. We string this world with lights to more clearly see the light of the one who is already here, Jesus Christ, who was, is, and is coming to show us his love for this world. Amen.
I invite you to confess your faith using the words of the Apostles' Creed. I believe in God, the Father Almighty, creator of heaven and earth. I believe in Jesus Christ, God's only Son, our Lord, who was conceived by the Holy Spirit, born of the Virgin Mary, suffered under Pontius Pilate, was crucified, died, and was buried. He descended to the dead. On the third day he rose again. He ascended into heaven. He is seated at the right hand of the Father, and he will come to judge the living and the dead. I believe in the Holy Spirit, the Holy Catholic Church, the communion of saints, the forgiveness of sins, the resurrection of the body, and the life everlasting. Amen. Let us pray. God, our helper, we thank you for keeping our lives always in your care and your protection. And we pray for any and all who are in harm's way, for those walking in the middle of danger, for those who walk the slippery path, for those exhausted and seeking rest, for those who face a mountain of worry or debt. Be guardian and guide, we pray, setting our feet on your paths of righteousness and peace. We pray for those who are struggling with a new challenge, with major transitions in life or livelihood, with their faith and understanding, with grief, old or new. Protect not only us, but the whole wide world you love. Where there is unrest and injustice, make justice our aim. Where hope has grown tired and thin, lift our sights so that we may see beyond hope and life beyond death and you. Lift it up before us, O God, In the name of Christ, who lives with you in the Holy Spirit forever and ever. Amen. The peace of Christ be with you always. I invite you to share God's peace with one another, either in the messages with the group you're with or via telephone, text message, whatever way you want to get it out there. God's peace. God's peace. The Lord be with you. I invite you to have your communion in front of you at this time. Just as we gather, we remember that Jesus and his followers, they gathered together as one people. And as they did, they watched as Jesus took bread, broke it, and gave it to each of his disciples, saying, "Take and eat. This is my body, given for you. Do this for the remembrance of me." Then he took a cup and passed it to all, saying, "This cup is the new covenant in my blood, shed for you and for all people for the forgiveness of sin. Do this in remembrance of me." As this meal is shared, let your grace pour out to all who participate with us now, even as we pray as Jesus taught us. Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. For thine is the kingdom and the power and the glory forever and ever. Amen. I invite you to share communion at home with your group that you're with as we do the same here. The body and blood of Christ given and shed for you. Let us pray. Gracious and abundant God, you have done great things for us, and we rejoice. In the bread and cup, you give us life forever. In your boundless mercy, strengthen us and open our hearts to the world's needs. For the sake of Jesus Christ, our Lord. Amen.
Trim the harlots and the table. People, look east.